What is going on, guys? Joe here from Ankle Athletics. Just want to talk about a question I received from one of my clients, and that is what you should do about tracking when you go out to eat. And the big thing I want to cover first is knowing your goals. If your goal is to reduce body fat and remain in a caloric deficit, you need to limit the amount of times you go out to eat as much as you can. The reason for this is the variability of those meals when you're going out to eat is going to be so difficult to determine and stay accurate with. So, in order to remain in that sustainable long-term caloric deficit, you need to make sure that you're limiting the amount of times that those variables are changing. So if you're able to eat at home, you're able to know what and how much, what oils you're using, all those sorts of things, and it'll allow you to eat a little bit better and more consistent towards your goals. Now, if your goal is to put on muscle mass and to remain in a caloric surplus, this isn't as vital. But at the same time, being able to manipulate your tracking, even when you go out to eat, is very crucial for long-term success. So what I would recommend is if you're gonna go out to eat, the main thing you need to do is budget those calories in for that time of day. Just like you budget in money, you need to make sure that if you're spending a lot of money, if you're eating a lot of food later in the day or whatever that may be, you need to budget the rest of your day accordingly. So let's say I know I'm going out for birthday dinner tonight. I'm gonna make sure that the rest of my day is adjusted accordingly, and what I might recommend even is looking up the restaurant that you're gonna be going to and finding out the meal that you're actually going to be having before you even step foot in the restaurant so that you know the rest of your day can be planned accordingly and you can still enjoy that meal guilt-free knowing you're on track with your overall calorie goals. Now, if you were to do this every single day, yes, it's going to have an effect on your diet and it's going to have effect on your long-term success, especially for someone looking to reduce body fat. But if you're someone trying to remain in that caloric surplus, the main thing you should be focusing on is eating enough. And if you're seeing that scale trend in whatever direction you're wanting it to over a weekly basis, then you're on track. Don't overanalyze the specifics of little things because that is going to drain you down and really keep you in a place where you're feeling like you can never stay on track because it's impossible to stay on track 100% of the time. The big thing you need to realize is that you're only human and that you can only do the best you can. Focus on building long-term sustainable habits and not focusing on short-term success. The thing you have to realize is that you don't have to be perfect, nor can you, but the ability to stay consistent 80% of the time or even 70% of the time is what is going to breed the results that you want over a lifetime. I hope this video helps and I hope that you can take something away from this and apply it to your own journey. Have a great day, guys.